Good morning. Here is today's word of blessings for you. Psalm 144:12-15. Then our sons in their youth will be like well-nurtured plants, and our daughters will be like pillars carved to adorn a palace. Our barns will be filled with every kind of provision. Our sheep will increase by thousands, by tens of thousands in our fields, our oxen will draw heavy loads. There will be no breaching of walls, no going into captivity, no cry of distress in our streets. Blessed is the people of whom this is true, blessed is the people whose God is the Lord. Today's title is Blessings of the People Whose God is the Lord. We know that there are many sufferings that God's people go through in this life. We often talk about it. We preach about it. That is a reality of our Christian life. We should not hide or brush up on such a reality. We don't want to mislead people with untrue optimism. Bible never does. But there are other things that we ought to remember and tell the people. What is it? It is that such suffering is not the whole story. We have greater blessings that come from God. We will receive such blessings fundamentally when we get to heaven. But God helps us to foretaste such heavenly blessings frequently, I mean frequently on earth. As a pastor, I have seen both sides of it through the lives of many people. And I personally believe that even in our earthly lives, the blessings of God weigh much more than the sufferings in our life. I surely have seen a lot of suffering, but I am sure that I have seen much more blessings poured upon the people of God. I believe today's psalm shows such earthly blessings that many people of God experience on earth. Although a great number of families encounter great challenges in raising their children, families with God's blessings often see the opposite reality. Then our sons in their youth will be like well-nurtured plants, and our daughters will be like pillars carved to adorn a palace. God somehow raises them in such an excellent way to become so superb in mind and body. They become greatly useful for both God and man. Finance is an everyday concern for most people. But God often fills His own people with abundance. Our barns will be filled with every kind of provision. Our sheep will increase by thousands, by tens of thousands in our fields. Not only that, God brings peace and security for those who truly love and serve Him. There will be no breaching of walls, no going into captivity, no cry of distress in our streets. Some might say that this is too good to be true. But for some blessed people, this is surely true. I believe that I have seen that it is true. My only hope is that it is true with everybody. I am sure that God has the same wish. So how could we possibly make God's wish come true?